What is up, ladies and gentle nerds? It is Graham, also known as HamHocks42, and this episode, as always, is brought to you by my buddy James, who took me aside in high school and said, "Hey man, you might want to try this card game. It's pretty fun." And yes, I know I'm already recycling that joke, but hey, it's okay. Because, there are only so many good jokes. And there's a really good chance that this is the first time you've been here, in which case, hey, welcome. Thanks so much for coming by. This is the show where we look at a random Magic card every freaking day and then discuss it for at least 10 minutes. And by discuss it, I mean I talk at you for about 10 minutes. So I'm on Gatherer, and I'm going to go ahead and click the random card button. Specifically, the button says View Card. And the name on the card that we got today is pretty fantastic, which, of course, you already know if you're looking down at your phone or if you saw the title on YouTube, depending on wherever you're seeing this. And the card is called Chaotic Goo. There are so many jokes that I could make there that, you know what? Those jokes kind of make themselves. So just, go ahead and think what you will. Whenever you hear the word goo, whatever you think of, which, yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and assume that it's not the slime from Nickelodeon. I could be wrong, but I mean it's also quite chaotic. Yikes! All right, and here we haven't even gotten into the card itself. So, Chaotic Goo is a rare from Tempest. It costs two generic and two red. And this is actually, it is a rare from Tempest, and the only reason I know it's a rare is because it's actually listed on Gatherer as being rare. Tempest actually did not have colored set symbols. All the cards from Tempest had a black set symbol, regardless of rarity. So that's kind of an interesting point. But they were still printed in, I mean, the rarities were relevant for the cards. They always were, but in this case, it doesn't show specifically on the card itself. Okay, so I know you're wondering, dude, what does Chaotic Goo do? Come on. And I think you and I, and chances are your laundry, already know. But here we go. Chaotic Goo, here's the Oracle text. So here's how it would play today. It is a creature ooze. Oof. Oh man, the jokes keep coming. Here it is. So Chaotic Goo enters the battlefield with 3 +1/+1 counters on it. Its base toughness and power are 0/0, by the way. At the beginning of your upkeep, you may flip a coin. If you win the flip, put a +1/+1 counter on Chaotic Goo. If you lose the flip, remove a +1/+1 counter from Chaotic Goo. All right, so at first you get a 3/3 for 4, not a great value, but okay. And then it has the potential, there's a 50-50 shot every single turn that it's going to grow. So this is interesting, and it's interesting that we got two like chaos coin flip cards in a row. I promise these are random, but yeah, that's interesting. So we had the fire cat yesterday as you're watching this. I believe I filmed that a couple of days ago, but that's behind the curtain. You don't need to worry about that. Anyway, so this particular so Chaotic Goo is a 3/3 for 4. You flip a coin. So best case scenario, it is a 4/4 for 4 after you've waited one turn with it chilling out as a 3/3. So this is it's not a very good value for what you're getting. That said, if you're running, a weird coin flippy deck where you're not as worried about particularly powerful payoffs, it could be fun. Now, that's really all it comes down to is this could be a fun thing because you have the opportunity to get it just crazy out of hand. But overall, it's not a very good value. It just isn't. It's unreliable, hence the name. I mean, and if you lose that first flip, you're sitting on turn 5. So a perfect situation. Well, I mean, perfect situation, there are ramps and things, but let's go ahead and just say that you hit all your land drops, you're playing on curve, you drop this on turn 4. The moment you hit turn 5, there's a potential that this creature went from a 3/3 down to a 2/2. Gah, that's terrible. I think best case scenario, this is one of those where, or if I were to fix this card, if I were to build this card today, I would recommend that it come in as a 5/5. Well, come in with 5 +1/+1 counters on it. That way, you're getting a creature that is bigger for its cost. So you're getting a 5/5 with the downside that it might get weaker over time. But you have the upside of possibly buffing it up a little bit. The other thing that's interesting, or at the very least, it doesn't have any keywords on it. It doesn't have trample, it doesn't have haste, it doesn't have first strike, it doesn't have protection from anything. It's It's just a creature. It's just it's a vanilla creature with an unreliable power and toughness stat line. I'm not digging that. Now, so we had the situation where you've got you have an option of putting this into a deck that's doing fun things with coin flips. Okay, that's one option. The other there are a couple other applications for this as well that are coming to mind. And they leverage one thing that I think is notable here, and that's the creature type. So its creature type is ooze. In the most recent Ravnica set, they actually came out with a card called Biogenic Ooze, which is literally an ooze lord. It gives all oozes +1/+1, and then it also creates ooze tokens and puts counters on ooze creatures. So this is a situation where if you could build an ooze tribal deck, and this could go into it. And then if you can combo that with something like, the other thing that comes to mind is Hydra's Growth, which is an aura that just came out in the in Theros Beyond Death, where it's an enchantment that during when it comes into play, you put a counter on a creature, just 1/+1/+1 counter, and then at your upkeep, you double the number of +1/+1 counters on that creature. So here's a situation where the creature already comes in with three. You have the potential of getting a fourth onto it on the next turn. So if you throw Hydra's Growth on it, all of a sudden the thing can grow pretty big. Now, a couple of problems with that. One, there are better options. Just candidly, there are the mana cost to power on this creature is just not that great, unfortunately. And with how many Hydras are bopping around, if you're running Ooze Tribal, you're definitely going to be running green. And I don't know how many other Ooze creatures you're going to be able to actually take advantage of with this. Never mind. So here's another application. If you actually are running a three color Ooze Tribal, you could theoretically run Chaotic Goo as your turn four, and if you have Prime Speaker Vanifar in your deck, because Biogenic Ooze costs five. Prime Speaker Vanifar is a birthing pod on a body. If you're not familiar with that, she's actually, if I'm remembering correctly, she's an elf ooze wizard or something like that. I remember, I think she's an elf ooze. Anyway, but I do know she has the creature type ooze. So she's an ooze. You know, she gets the benefit of all of this stuff. So she can fit into an ooze tribal deck. She can kind of spearhead an ooze tribal deck pretty comfortably. And with her ability, you sacrifice a creature, search your library for any creature with the same converted mana cost +1, and put that into play. So Chaotic Goo here costs one less than the Biogenic Ooze. So that said, if you are thinking about building an ooze tribal deck, although actually now that I was just thinking about some kind of commander where you build a commander deck around oozes, which could be a lot of fun. And I'm trying to think, how could you get Chaotic Goo, Prime Speaker Vanifar? Well, Prime Speaker Vanifar and Chaotic Goo in the same deck. You're gonna have to have access to red, blue, and green. So that might be a little tricky. And unfortunately, you wouldn't be able to have Vanifar as your commander if you were going to take advantage of Chaotic Goo, just because it's red, so that doesn't fit her color identity. But the idea is you'd be able to play Chaotic Goo, sacrifice it to Prime Speaker Vanifar's ability, and fetch out your Biogenic Ooze and get that on the field. So that's interesting. There's something there. That's kind of fun. Yeah, in general, don't play this card. But if you have counter shenanigans, also it's a red card that comes into play with a bunch of +1/+1 counters on it. There are some ways to take advantage of that. There's some ways to abuse counters that does exist. I'm thinking of cards like Ulast, the Hate Seed, where it creates tokens and it leverages counters on it. I don't believe it touches counters on other creatures, unfortunately. I'm fairly certain there are ways to leverage that to good effect. Proliferate comes to mind. So if you have a deck that cares about counters in that way, where you're proliferating consistently, I mean there's a possibility there that could work. If you want to take like Atraxa and power her down, which if you wanted to play a power down commander deck, just don't play Atraxa because she's just freaking amazing top to bottom. But if you wanted to have that like proliferate effect and just really lean into that and just create find a bunch of fun ways to get fun, interesting counters down. Chaotic Goo could be pretty fun. If nothing else, just for the other players' reactions when you say the name of this card as you put it into play. Just Chaotic Goo. Yeah, I guess that's the real value in this card. The real value is the name. And I have no doubt that if we looked at the discussion from this here on Gatherer, there would be some interesting comments. And you know what? Let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to go ahead and click over to the discussion, which is something that Gatherer currently doesn't support, but it used to. And some of these are still up and running. And it basically is just a forum. So let's go ahead and take a look. Yeah, Lawful Evil, Goo you can stretch. It's like Taffy. Looks great with Chance Encounter, which is from Odyssey. It's an enchantment for 4. Whenever you win a coin flip, put a luck counter on Chance Encounter at the beginning of your upkeep. If Chance Encounter has 10 or more luck counters on it, you win the game. That's exactly what this is for. Holy crap, that's perfect. If you have a Chance Encounter deck, run Krark's Thumb, every single thing with coin flips that you can think of, and you know what? This Goo should be in the mix. That's beautiful. I was unaware of Chance Encounter. Holy crap, that's perfect. What else we got? And that is posted by Gelzo back in 2010. So Gelzo, if you are watching this, well done, sir. That's exactly right. What else? Yes, 3 stars simply because it's one of the most fun cards in the set. It is a 3/3 for 4, but it can get much larger each turn. Great in some kind of ooze deck that uses cards that Blood Hall Ooze. I'm not familiar with that. To get a bunch of 0/0 creatures with tons of counters. Yep, there it is. So yeah, that's it. Yeah, I mean, there we have it, folks. Chaotic Goo, and the artwork. All this time, I've just been hung up on the name and the rules. So the artwork. It's really tough to tell exactly what's going on here. It's clearly some kind of pinkish goo that's being stretched across some... the sense of context here is really rough, because it's tough to tell if it's on, like, a mountainside, or if it's... Yeah, I think that's it. I think it's on a mountainside, and it's just kind of stretching from one place to another. It's really tough to tell. The sense of scale is not really here, unfortunately. It looks like it's just a big thing of pink goo that's being stretched out over a long stretch, or along a fairly large location, along a large place. Yeah, I don't know how else to describe it. It's really kind of awkward, if I'm honest. It looks like if your Play-Doh decided, if you were stretching out Play-Doh and really getting angry at it as a kid, and it decided to get mad and try to fight back, this is what you would get, I would imagine. So go ahead and look that up. Chaotic Goo from Tempest. It's a rare. I gotta say, if I cracked this as a rare in my pack, I'd be pretty frustrated. But in general, I don't know. It's something you can play around with and have some fun with. But if the real value is tapping 4 mana and then telling your friends, I play Chaotic Goo. Or if you really want to be graphic, you can say Chaotic Goo is coming out of your hand. Anyway, thanks so much for hanging out, guys. You're the best. This has been a weird one, but here we are. And I hope you're having a great day, great evening, great morning, whenever, whatever time it is for you. And I will catch you next time. Later.